Dear Konami, this needs to get fixed. It's 2019. You guys gotta fix this. New year, new Konami, okay? Let's do it together. What's going on, YouTube? This is your boy Sam from Team Zamreaction here. And today, guys, I'm coming at you with another Dear Konami video. You guys love videos like these when I address Konami one-on-one, and I just basically try to communicate myself on behalf of me and, of course, you guys to try to send a message to Konami. As New Year starts, I want to try to send out a message to Konami as quickly as possible so, you know, they can try to fix these problems that the game has been having for quite a long time. And I feel like it's important to make videos like these is because, you know, we are the fan base. We are the player base for Yu-Gi-Oh! And if Konami wants the game to run properly and if Konami wants the game to be healthy, obviously it is really good to actually get, you know, the voices of the fans that are playing Yu-Gi-Oh! Every single day. Maybe some of the things I will be talking about in this video will probably never come true, you know, to you guys, Konami, you're watching this video. But I really feel like it's really important, you know, as, you know, a content creator and as a person that has a huge platform on YouTube, you know, to actually voice my opinions on behalf of all the players in Yu-Gi-Oh! So try to just basically communicate with you guys on how you guys will fix the game for 2019. If you guys want to see more videos like these, make sure you guys smash that thumbs up button. That'll be absolutely amazing. And if you guys want to help support the channel, make sure you guys visit txs1.com to get your playmats today. No further ado, let's dive straight into the video. It is obviously 2:40 a.m. in the morning, so I just want to, you know, go straight to the point. As you guys all know, for Yu-Gi-Oh! 2018, one of the most problematic things that was implemented into the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Which stirred up a lot of players' anger, frustration. Yeah, basically the new time rules. Now, for those of you who play competitive Yu-Gi-Oh, you guys know that the time rules has been implemented in 2018, and in my personal opinion, it's one of the worst things that actually has ever happened. Previously to the brand new time rules, whenever time is called in the Yu-Gi-Oh event, so basically 40 minutes, you and your opponent has exactly 5 turns to complete the entire game. You know, obviously after that 5 turns, you can now determine who is the winner by whoever has the most game won or whoever has the highest life points. That's how Yu-Gi-Oh used to work back in the day without the brand new time rule. And now with the new time rule is whenever time is called, whoever has the most life points just wins the duel. So let's say that you're at 8,000, and there's exactly 30 seconds left on the clock, and you draw for turn, okay? And you take 400 damage off Trickstar Lycoris because you drew one card, and then you're trying to make your plays during your main phase, and then time is called. You will now have a chance to finish your current phase, and if you, after you finish your current phase, it is the end of the entire match, and then you determine the winner of that game on whoever has the highest life points. And it just caused so many problems this year because, you know, a lot of people are just really frustrated because some people will slow play, some players will take 15 minutes to combo off, and it's got a lot of players very angry and frustrated because now the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Has basically have gone to a light points game. So whoever has the highest light points just automatically win the duel, whereas previously, you know, you actually had a chance to actually duke it out within those 5 turns. So that was just a huge problem, and it just caused a lot of players to not want to play the game. And I seen some Facebook groups that actually, you know, wrote a petition to try to actually make Konami stop these new time rules. So obviously the time rule was a huge problem, and how Konami can fix this in 2019 is to basically follow the OCG. So basically, I played in the OCG for one format when I went to Thailand last year, and how the OCG time rule worked was that you have 35 minutes for the entire match. For the entire round, you have 35 minutes. Once 35 minutes time is called, you and your opponent have exactly 10 minutes to complete the entire end of match procedure. Also, there's a catch. You and your opponent have exactly 3 turns to complete the match as well. You have exactly 10 minutes and 3 turns to complete the entire match. So, you know, you still get to play, you still got time left, and you still, you know, got 3 turns to potentially just decide who the winner of the game or match is. And playing in a format like that in the OCG, I really thought that it was one of the most organized things ever, because once a judge calls time, there's a 10 minute clock. Like, within that 10 minutes, you have 3 turns to complete the match slash game. And if the 10 minutes is up, whoever has the highest life points just wins the duel. And I truly believe that giving players the opportunity to actually finish the match fairly without having to worry too much about who has the highest life points, probably one of the most fairest thing that Konami could offer to Yu-Gi-Oh! In the TCG. And if they can't complete the match within 10 minutes, then the match is over. Then whoever has the highest life points by when time is called, then you are the winner. One of the most successful things that Yu-Gi-Oh! Had back in the day was the proper banlist structure. What does that mean for those of you who are watching this video and are new to the game of Yu-Gi-Oh? Every 3 or every 6 months, Konami will give you the exact date on when the ban list will drop.
Bro, you good?
Man, I'm really just sick of this format. Teledad's ruining everything.
Man, look, the way I see it, March 1st, like always, we get a new ban list.
You know, I guess you're right. I'm so glad Konami gives us that thing on schedule.
So you guys can prepare on what cards to get rid of, what cards to potentially pick up. You know, it just creates an overall healthy community. But now, in Yu-Gi-Oh, okay, there's none of that. On the ban list page right now, it says no sooner than January. No sooner than January. What the heck does that mean? It's January. Where's the ban list, right? Like, we don't know. Is it January 1st? Is it January 4th? Is it January 31st?
Hey, man, has the ban list dropped yet?
Nah, but I'm still refreshing this page.
What you mean by not yet? They said before January, and it's January 1st, and I need Construct back.
Man, I just want them to get rid of Rongo.
I'm really cool with that, too.
And you guys don't know when ban list season hits. We all get frustrated because we do not know when the ban list is. Konami does not give us a proper ban list structure for the player base. And I really believe that for 2019, Konami should fix that up. If I were to run a business, I myself want the customers to be happy. I run a YouTube channel. I want my subscribers to be happy on the content I post. If the player base are happy, the game becomes more successful. You know, I'm not here to bash you guys. I just really want to give you guys constructive criticism on how you guys can improve the game. And I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys will be happy too if you guys know the exact date on the ban list. Most oftentimes, ban lists will drop a week before YCS. How are we as a player supposed to playtest for specific events if we do not know the exact date on when the balance is gonna drop? Are we just gonna go into those competitive events blind and not know what to test or not know what to play? Players invest in so much money to play this game. We buy your products, we fly to events, we drive to your events, we go to your events. You guys had it back in the day. Why take it out? Implementing a proper balance structure would definitely 100,000% make the fan base happy. And it's a ripple effect. If the fan base is happy, the game is happy. If the game is happy, the game becomes more successful. And the next thing that I like to talk about is Yu-Gi-Oh! For beginners. I truly believe that Konami should implement something for beginners in Yu-Gi-Oh! Maybe host an OTS tournament, you know, every Saturday morning, you know, at your nearest OTS stores, and basically have the OTS, you know, store, you know, teach people on how to play Yu-Gi-Oh! And I truly believe that this is a crucial part in building up a community. And I have some players that just returning to the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! That don't even know what Pendulum Summoning is, or don't even know what XYZ Summoning is, you know what I mean? I really believe that it would be really beneficial to actually have OTS stores host beginner tournaments for beginners, for people that do not know how to play Yu-Gi-Oh! So they can teach the new players on how to play, or to basically just refresh their memory on how the game of Yu-Gi-Oh! Worked. Maybe at a YCS or at a regional, Konami staffs or judges host, you know, beginner tournaments on the side for those who are new to the game, give these players new tips or strategies on how they can basically get back into the game. And in this video, I am not here to talk about FTKs, Konami should stop FTKs, Konami should yada yada yada, do whatever. That's just how the game is. And that entire category, Konami should stop this, should stop wrong, we should stop all of that, is definitely related to the ban list category. So I'm obviously not gonna talk about that. The next thing I can talk about may not, you know, deal directly to you guys, but it does affect the content creators. I truly believe that Konami should help out content creators no matter how big or no matter how small. I don't even know if you guys know this, but Konami EU had like a creator day for the creators in Europe, and they invited all those content creators like Jamie the Kid 00, you know, showcase the new products that they had and just basically just worked with them. So I really believe that Konami TCG in North America should definitely implement something like this. Can you imagine if I actually worked with Konami, you know, and the YouTube channels that you guys all favored did a collab with Konami? That would be super duper sick. Can you imagine if, you know, content creators got exclusive insight on the next release, or, you know, they give us sneak peeks on what's gonna be coming out and things like that? That would be really cool because we're gonna be able to share it with the fan base, right? I really believe that it will be really beneficial for both Konami and the content creators if they work together in 2019, and I really believe that they can overall build a very strong and healthy community for this game. I know a lot of people that play Magic. Magic love to help out their content creators. Pokemon loves to help out their content creators. So I don't understand why Yu-Gi-Oh! Can't do the exact same thing. You know, like, help a brother out We're here to actually help promote your game, so I don't know why you guys can't work with us. You know, Konami, a shout out to you guys. You guys did a really wonderful thing this year, especially Konami on North America, where you guys set up a YouTube recording area for YCSs. But we're only restricted to record in one area, you know what I mean? Before, I was able to do vlogs. You guys all remember those vlogs when I was able to travel around the YCS venue and just showcase all my fans? That was sick. I can't do that anymore. It's because I'm only restricted to record in that one single area. So I don't understand why Konami can't just let us, you know, record around the entire venue. We're here to promote your game, you know what I mean? So Konami 2019, I really believe that it would be really cool if you guys would just let us record around the entire thing, you know what I mean? Like, we go to your events, we go to your regionals, it's because we love the game. Help the content creators out a little bit, you know what I mean, Konami? So let's work together for 2019. That would be super duper sick. And another thing that you guys will probably want me to talk about is Konami needs to stop reprints. Konami needs to stop making cards so expensive, yada yada yada. You guys have to understand, from a marketing standpoint, like, Konami is not gonna guarantee you an Ash Blossom in every single pack in Dual Power. They're not gonna make money, like, you know what I mean? Like, if every box came with Ash Blossom, how is Konami gonna make money? You know what I mean? Like, I can't really say Konami needs to stop short prints. Obviously, short print sucks. Hey, they need to make money somehow, right? But one other thing that they should do is do the exact same thing that OCG does. So if OCG gets an Ash Blossom in that structure deck, we should get an Ash Blossom in that structure deck too. Not some stupid shining angel. Pretty much for this video, hopefully you guys enjoy. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you guys smash the thumbs up button. That'll be absolutely amazing. Let me know what you guys think about this video. It's obviously hard to talk to Konami one-on-one, but if I'm actually able to use my platform for good and try to send a message for Konami on how, you know, they can fix the game to make the players, you know, more happy and more satisfied, I would definitely love to do that. And let me know what your thoughts are. And this video is not me complaining. This video is just me telling Konami on how they can fix the game in 2019. I'm not complaining. I'm not mad. I love the way the game is. You know what I mean? But there are obviously ways on how Konami could definitely make it better. This is your boy Sam from Team Sansa Sam signing out. All right, guys. Peace. And yes, okay, I am wearing a Thrasher shirt, okay? I don't skate, and I got this as a present. I feel like Usain in a cheetah print. Talk fresh game, I don't need a mint. R.I.P. the game, shh, I need a minute. Okay, let's proceed with it. I'm in the house, got the deed with it. These bozos always sneak this, and they taking shots, I'ma keep with it. Like, no, this league business. Ooh, you